Welcome to the County Ground Chelmsford, the home of Essex cricket. I played here for 24 seasons, winning 6 county championships. It's a great place to play and a wonderful place to watch cricket. It's another big summer for one Essex man in particular, England captain Alistair Cook, as he looks to rebuild the side. And as we've already seen with Sam Robson, Moeen Ali and Chris Jordan recently making their test debuts, the LV County Championship really is the platform for guys who force their way into that test team. And this is the show that brings you closer to those players. So let's see what's coming up. England star Ravi Bopara talks about his hopes and ambitions for the season with both Essex and England. It's a contest between batsman and bowler in bat versus ball. And can the Essex boys outrun those England legends as they take their turn on the stickiest of wickets? I'm joined by one of Essex's most senior and influential players, Ravi Bopara. Welcome, Ravi. It's 14 seasons since I gave you your Essex debut at Northampton. Where do you see yourself at the moment?
Well, I feel old now that you said 14 years. I see myself in a good place right now. I've been playing some good cricket this year with Essex. The last couple of years have gone quite well. I've played a lot of one-day cricket for England. But I think it's about time that I started breaking back into that test team again. My ambitions are to go and play at the highest level with the red ball as well, not just the white ball. So I'm very keen to see how I go now.
You played 108 matches, scored lots of runs in one day cricket, only 13 tests, 300s there. Test cricket has stalled a bit for you. What do you see your future there and how you can get back in the side and show a bit of consistency?
There's only one way to get back in, Gray, and that's just sheer weight of runs. I don't think I'm going to get in on one-day form. I've got to go out for Essex in four-day cricket and score big hundreds. Not 40s, not 50s, not 80s, not 90s. I've got to get 100, 150, 180s, double hundreds and keep knocking on that door so they can't ignore me. I'm keen to do it. I'm desperate to do it without losing my focus. I don't want to finish my career playing county cricket, because that's not what I set out to do from the start.
You know, you've batted nearly all the positions in one day cricket and test cricket, you know, from 3 to 4 to 6 to 7 sometimes. What do you feel is your best position and how do you feel you can achieve that consistency?
I'd say my best position is top of the order. I'm certainly not a number 6 or a 7. I haven't practiced all my life and played all my life at county level to be a number 6. It's not the way I approached my training through all these years. I've always wanted to be a top order batsman, make impacts on games from the start. I've definitely been more consistent over the last few years now, and more consistent as a bloke as well. Whether I get naught or I get 100, I still try to behave the same way and do the same things. Because I think it just breeds consistency. You know, it's the sort of thing where you train yourself to be consistent. So that's helped me a lot. And I think having a family as well has helped me a lot. It took my focus, not my focus away from cricket, but it's just given me something else. And I think that's important as a sportsman.
Just here today, the county ground at Chelmsford, great place to play cricket. I would say that having spent most of my life here, great place to bat. How do you see it for Essex this season in the county championship?
I thought we've played really good cricket. I think we've been hard done by the rain, the weather. There was a few games where we were in very strong position, couldn't finish because there was not enough time. But we've said it for many years now that we want to get promoted and play Division 1 cricket. And just like any plan, it takes years to get it right. And we're getting there, we're getting better.
It's a good mix, I think, in the Essex lineup. You've got some experience in Tendo, James Foster, David Masters, Graham Napier. Then you've got some good youngsters, Rita Topley, Ben Folkes, Jake Micklebury, Tom Wesley. How do you see some of these players for the future going through?
I think the future looks bright for Essex. We've always produced good cricketers at Essex. We're one of those counties that, you know, keeps producing them. And
the Ilford Cricket School.
Good old Ilford Cricket School. We've always produced good cricketers who've gone on and played for, you know, represented the countries like Alistair Cook, etc. So, and yourself, Gray. And we have got some good youngsters coming through. Like you said, you mentioned the names of Rhys Topley, who keeps taking wickets, keeps finding ways to take wickets, which is always a good thing. And who's really, really impressed me this year has been Tom Wesley. How much he's improved as a batsman has been phenomenal. And I'm glad to see it, because I remember batting up the other end with him and thinking this guy could be a serious player. And it looks as if he's turning into a proper player. And I said a few weeks ago in an interview that, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if he went on and played for England one day.
Well, like yourself, he's a bit of an all-rounder, bowls off spin as well, so he's got two chances if you ask me, and I agree with you, he's made good progress. Well, it's been fantastic chatting to you today, giving your time up before you go and prepare yourself to score what you do best, is score hundreds. And I just hope, having known you for a decade or so now, you're a good lad, been a good cricketer for England and Essex. Go and fulfil your destiny and be a champion. Thanks, Ravi. Next, it's quiz time, and we have a run maker and wicket taker going head to head.
Hi, my name's Ben Folkes, and my buzzer sounds like this.
Hi, I'm Rhys Topley, and my buzzer sounds like this.
OK, the rules are simple. They buzz if they know the answer. If they get it wrong, it goes to the opponent. Simple rules, simple questions. Who holds the records for the most runs for Essex and England?
Ben Gooch.
Correct. Which current Essex player has hit a record 16 sixes in one innings?
Graham Napier.
Correct. How many times have Essex won the county championships?
Six,
correct. Who was Essex's top scorer in county championship last season?
Jake Micklebury.
Correct. Which Essex player was born on Christmas Day?
Alistair Cook.
Correct. Coach Paul Grayson's brother, Simon, is the manager of which football club?
Preston North End.
Correct. Which Essex player has the most Twitter followers?
Ravi
Bopara. Correct. Who was Essex's leading wicket taker in 2013 in the county championship?
Rhys Topley.
David Masters.
I'm shocked.
Before Alistair Cook, who was the last Essex player to captain England?
Is it Nasser? I think Nasser's
correct. Name. Well, that's a resounding victory for Rhys Topley for the bowlers. Who says the bowlers are thick? The batsman won at Surrey, but here the bowler had the upper hand and they can celebrate their first win of the series. Now it's time to turn the spotlight on me for Over and Out. My idol as a sportsman when I was growing up was Bobby Moore. Being captain of England, captain of West Ham, he was an ambassador for his sport, a great role model. As far as cricket concerned, I didn't have a major cricketing idol, but of course the star player in my youth was Sir Garfield Sobers. What a cricketer. That's reasonably easy on the England setup because Sir Ian Botham would be the most dynamic cricketer I played with. He was always one to watch. He was one that got people out of the dressing room onto the balcony to watch him bat, and he always had something up his sleeve with the ball. Wonderful cricketer. My best bowling attack I would have ever faced would have been Malcolm Marshall, Dennis Lilly, Wasim Akram, Shane Warne. But if I had to pick one of those, it would be Malcolm Marshall. He had everything as a bowler. Pace, stamina, intelligence, could work out how to get a batsman out, and was a great opponent. And he always bowled well against Essex as well. I don't think there's a ground to surpass Lords in the world. Newlands in Cape Town will be my number two, but Lords has everything. It has the history, it has the tradition, and it has that class about it when you go there. Everything about Lords is class, and when you walk through the long room out onto that turf, it makes you feel special. I don't have a personal milestone in terms of scoring runs. I think when you represent your country, that is a boyhood dream. But when you are asked to captain the other players and lead them out in an international match, a test match, an ODI, T20, or whatever it is nowadays, there's no higher honour and no more responsibility you can receive. Well, in terms of Essex, I think one of their brightest stars is Ben Folkes. I worked with him a lot in 2013. He's an excellent young lad, good student of the game, very good with the bat, and will have a big career behind the stumps. Big future in front of him. As far as England concerned, the wider, I think Gary Balance has started his test career very well in the few matches he's played. Head screwed on, nice compact player, and I think he will make a big difference for England going forward. Next is a challenge with a real difference. This is Sticky Wicket. It's a timed obstacle relay race with three players required to navigate up and down the course, all the time juggling a ball on a bat. There's a 5-second penalty if they drop the ball and a 10-second penalty for any shortcuts. Time to meet the contestants.
Hello, we're Team Essex. I'm Ben Folkes and I'm a keeper batsman.
I'm David Masters and I am the fast and nasty Essex bowler.
I'm Rhys Topley, I'm a fast bowler. We're about to do the Sticky Wicket Challenge.
3, 2, 1, go! Yes, Jules! Yes, yes, that's good, that's good, that's good, that's good, very good! Very good, Hoddy! Come on, Hoddy, go there. Oh, come on! Yes, Hoddy, yes, Hoddy! Good, good!
Is it fine if you touch anything?
Come on, that's good, good, toppers. Excellent, this is good stuff, good stuff. Good work! Good work, good work!
Come on, toppers!
Good work, brilliant, brilliant work. Well, that's really quick. Brilliant, come on, Ben. Don't let us down, Ben. Don't let us down, that's good. Good work, Ben, good. Look at that, pace. That's brilliant.
And Ben, one batsman we got. You go, Ben.
The Essex Sticky Wicket Challenge time is 43 seconds dead, and with a 5-second penalty, makes 48 seconds, which puts the Essex team top of the league.
Yeah! Top of the league, top of the league.
And that's about it from beautiful Chelmsford. Don't forget, you can follow us on both Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for joining us. I hope to see you soon. Now, I'm going to watch some cricket.